our story.
My name is Julie. My actual name is Agnish Prasad, and I go by Julie, and I've been here in the United States for 25 years. I migrated here October 4th, 1992, from Fiji Islands. And the process it took me to get here was 12 years. My uncle sponsored me and my family to come to United States, and it's a 10-year difference. You have to wait for the immigration, for the paperwork, and then a whole year for the police just to get your clearance out. So the process is like up to 10 to 12 years to migrate to US. And Fiji is, it's very overpopulated country, and it's a multicultural country for Indians, Japanese, Fijians. They all live there. And the year 1879, January, Indian people were shipped out from India to Fiji to do the cotton plantation. And since then, the Indian people has been outgrowing their generations over generations in Fiji. And Fiji is actually a country of Fijian people. They are Native American people. It's like the Native Americans. And there is, that's how it's been growing up. That's how Indian people from India, they ended up in Fiji. They had to go do the coal plantations, cotton plantations. And since from there, it's just generations, and that's how we all ended up in Fiji. And the reason we migrated here is because of the poverty, the overpopulated population, and there's, you know, everything is so expensive. There's not enough money there. You know, my dad, he's a tailor, and he used to have a shop really like right on the street to make us living, you know, and my parents, my dad and my mom. My mom used to raise chickens and ducks, and I used to help my mom bring money in the house. You know, after I get up from school, I would come home and, you know, help her do anything to bring in the money. And so we can all have food to eat and clothing. And, you know, my uncle, who's actually like a god to us, who made our life so much better here by bringing us here. You know, I'm very thankful because Fiji is, there is hardly, you know, there's no money over there. You know, the schooling is so expensive. There's hardly any jobs out there. And the money that they make from the jobs are not enough. And everything, the groceries is so expensive. The school fees are so expensive. And a lot of parents can't afford schooling, and they cannot afford food and shelter. And that's one of the reasons that everybody's have a dream to migrate to overseas, you know, such as America and Australia, New Zealand, anywhere they find the opportunities to come here. Either it's a tourist visa or a visiting visa, or, you know, anything that they could just get sponsored by any of their family members to come here. And you know, I'm very blessed to be here today and able to provide everything for my kids. You know, I have a better job for the better opportunity. My husband, you know, they're able to get everything that they want, which we couldn't have. You know, there were times my dad, he didn't have money to buy us actual food, so we would go drink a glass of water before we go to bed. That was our dinner. And I just, you know, I hope nobody else goes through what we went through to Fiji, you know. And this is my daughter. You know, I'm always like telling her that we shouldn't be forgetting our roots. We are Indians, and this is what we're going to be. And we shouldn't be ashamed of ourselves. And, you know, I want her to be in touch with our Indian culture, Indian religions, and, you know, just to be proud to be an Indian. Thank you.